News 8's Commitment 2010 coverage continues now with the candidates in the race for Pennsylvania's 41st Legislative District, which covers part of Lancaster County. Republican Representative Katie True was elected to the seat in 2002. She's retiring when her term ends at the end of the year. And Republican Ryan Aument currently serves as Lancaster County's Clerk of Courts. He is being challenged in the race by Democrat Jerry Policoff. And we thank you both for joining us here today. Why do you want to go to Harrisburg?
Well, I think the challenges are great, and I think the times require decisive, dynamic leadership to confront a tough economic environment in this state. I think we need to make Pennsylvania more business-friendly. I think we've got a 9.2% unemployment rate.
All right, let's hang on there for a minute and not get into everything and give Jerry a chance to tell us also why you want to go to Harrisburg.
Well, you know, I never, ever contemplated running for office. I spent my life 40 years in the advertising business, and I worked here. I got very involved in, I've been involved in politics all my life, but I got very involved in the single-payer health care battle, and we've made a lot of progress in that. And one day the Democrats came to me and asked me if I'd like to run. And my first response was, why would I want to do that? And when I thought about it, I realized you can't want to make a difference and say you want to make a difference and walk away from that kind of an opportunity. So
all right.
The second time I said yes.
All right, very good. You both have said yes. You mentioned the corporate income tax. That's been a big thing, I guess, for you on the campaign trail,
that's
trying
right.
to lower that. But isn't it true that many corporations don't actually end up paying that 9.9%? Many are registered in Delaware, as we call it, the Delaware tax loophole. What's your reaction to that?
Well, my reaction is I think businesses are generally overtaxed in this state. I think the regulatory burden is great. I think the tax burden on businesses are great. And I think at a time when you have unemployment that is at 9.2%, if you look at a younger generation of those that are coming out of college in this state, the unemployment rate is closer to 18%. And if you look at those that are underemployed, that are actually employed in positions well below what they've been trained, that's nearly a third, nearly 33%.
So how do you cut the
corporate
income tax rate?
I think we reduce the corporate tax rate. I think you eliminate the capital stock and franchise tax. I think we take a serious look at the regulatory burden on business. And we've got to be intellectually honest enough and say if we're going to cut taxes, we've got to get our budget in line and reduce spending. Spending has gotten out of control over the course of the last 8 years of Governor Rendell. We've got spending under control.
We'll get back to that in a moment. Jerry, what about the corporate income tax and the burden on corporations in Pennsylvania?
Well, I agree that we need to lower the corporate income tax, but the way to do that is to close the Delaware loophole. There are 20 other states that have done that. Right now, because 79% of the corporations doing business here pay no taxes, the 21% that do are left with paying an unfair burden, and especially small business. And the bottom line is if we get rid of the Delaware loophole, then we can lower the tax, and it's fairer to everybody. There's no reason for us to have such a high tax. And it goes across the board. We're the only state that doesn't have a severance tax on gas. We're the only state that doesn't tax all tobacco products. The bottom line is that corporations get a free ride here, and it's the people that of Pennsylvania that are getting shortchanged because we don't have money to fund the projects that need to be funded.
All right, you mentioned the budget. I'd like to ask both of you, what one thing would you go right in there and try to cut?
Well, I think I would reject the notion that we have a taxing problem in the state. I mean, the initial part of the discussion, we've talked about the corporate tax, we've talked about the severance tax, and I think the severance tax is a dangerous idea at the point in which the Marcellus Shale is such an important early stages of development. I think specifically there's a number of opportunities for significant savings in the state budget. The Democrat Auditor General, Jack Wagner, has identified $1 billion of waste, of fraud in the Department of Welfare. I think that's a good place to look. I think there are opportunities for privatization, whether it's prisons, whether it's the state liquor stores. I think there are plenty of opportunities. And I think in terms of spending, we've got to now begin to take a serious look at the looming pension crisis that is going to have a severe economic impact on the state if we don't have leaders with courage and boldness to deal with the pension crisis.
All right. In fact, you want to privatize the state store system?
I would be supportive of that effort.
All right. And Jerry, what budget items would you look at to cut?
First of all, I'm in favor of cutting the size of the state legislature. It's too big. We're the most expensive legislature in the United States. I wouldn't be against privatizing the state liquor stores. I think we should look at it and study it. But I believe if we take advantage of the opportunities that are out there for us. The money is there to fund the things we need to fund. I've identified over $5 billion that we could raise without raising anybody's taxes, just by doing the common sense things that most states do. So I agree there's welfare fraud that needs to be fixed. There's also contract fraud that needs to be fixed. We've identified possibly as much as $2 billion in overpayments and outright fraud in contracts with the private sector. And we need the private sector, but it shouldn't be a license to steal money. It should be responsible. There should be oversight, and this is the people's money, and the corruption has to go and the overpayments have to go.
All right. One last word.
Well, I think he's exactly right in terms of the reform issues and taking a serious look at the legislature. Whether we go to a part-time legislature, reducing the size of the legislature, certainly real reform is needed there. And I'm absolutely supportive of those efforts as well.
All right. Very good. Thank you both for being here. We appreciate it. We could go on all day, but unfortunately we're out of time. But we thank you for joining us here today.